Hey guys, my name is Sachin and welcome to another very exciting After Effects tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to properly green screen in Adobe After Effects. Green screening is a fundamental technique that is used in one form or another in a very large number of visual effects. It is a simple technique of placing a subject in front of a green or blue background so that you can later remove the background and replace it with any piece of footage that you want. But before that, if you are new to my channel, please subscribe it and like. Please watch the video till the end because it will support me to grow my channel. So why green screen or blue screen specifically? Because the subject in front of your green screen is usually going to be a human, and neither green or no blue are very common skin colors. This makes it relatively easy to remove the background by simply trimming everything that is green or everything that is blue out of your footage. So let's go to After Effects and let's see how we are going to remove the green screen. So let's first create an empty composition. Now let's drag the green screen footage we have into our composition. As always, I will provide links to all of the videos I'm going to use in this tutorial down in the description of the video if you want to follow along. I'm going to show you two effects to remove the green screen, or rather you can say two methods. The first effect we are going to use to remove green screen, for that let's go to Effects and Presets, search key and look for linear color key. Now just drag and drop. This effect is not much complicated and it's very simple. Let's simply focus on removing the green screen here. Select the color picker from the key color property and then just click on your green screen. There you go, it's almost done. Most of your green screen has been removed now. You can see here some of the remainings are on the hands or on the hairs, which we can remove or refine by adjusting the matching tolerance property. By increasing the value, you can see the transparency of the footage is reducing. We can also view it in matte mode so that we can see how much green screen is left. We can also zoom in and pick the shades of green so that we can remove and refine the keying more precisely. We can also adjust the matching softness property to refine the edges of the character. So with this effect, we can reach to this level only. Now let's see another method of removing the green screen, and my favorite one. The effect we are going to use is called key light. Go to Effects and Presets and search for key light effect. Just drag and drop on your footage. The key light effect is actually pretty complicated and contains a large amount of settings that I'm not going to touch on here. Let's simply focus on removing the green screen for this particular shot that we have here. So select the color picker for the screen color property and then click on your green screen. Try to click on the fairly neutral area on your green screen. Avoid the highlights and avoid the dark areas. So we are almost done. Now most of our green screen has been removed by default. But there are some remainings you can see here. Some leftovers of the green screen depending on your setup. To fix this, we will have to tweak the screen map that is being applied by the key light effect. Go to the view mode and change the view to screen map. The screen you are seeing here is a preview window which has a calculated grayscale image that defines how transparent the different parts of your final footage will be when the screen matte is black. So in your final video, the screen that is white will be fully opaque and the green screen will be fully transparent. So what we are going to achieve in this screen is, the anchor in this case will try to make it fully white and the green screen will try to make it solid black. The easiest way to achieve this is to expand the screen map tab, which is already open here, and then increase the clip black property to trim out most of the green screen. But if you quickly zoom in, you can still see there are few dark spots around the anchor body. This means that some part of the background is still there, which is semi-transparent, which we want to fix. Now reduce the clip white property to completely solidify your anchor. So now let's go back and check your final green screen result. Let's change the view back to final results. Bam! That's looking really good. My advice to you guys is that try to keep your clip black value as low as possible and your clip white property as high as possible. But one thing is there, the edges of the anchor body are little harsh, or you can say are little jagged. This is because we have very strong values of clip black and white properties. So in order to soften out that, what we can do is we can play with the screen shrink and grow property. I think I will leave the screen shrink and grow property to 0, but I will increase the screen softness here. This will blur out the edges between your foreground and your background, but it will make it look more organic. Just a little bit of it, I think 0.5 or maybe a little lower, let's say to 0.3 to soften the edges. Yeah, right. So now we are almost done here. Now the whole point of removing your green screen is that you want to place your anchor in front of a different background, right? Which I have shown you in the start of the tutorial. So let's drag it into a composition and place it below the anchor video. Yes. We might have to adjust the angle a little bit to place it on the corner or to place it on the side. Yeah, there you go. Let's play it. So now our anchor is in newsroom putting the weather report. I really hope you enjoyed this video. As always, if you have any comments, questions or suggestions, just leave them down in the section below. If you want to see more cool After Effects tutorials, make sure to subscribe to my channel. And I will be greatly appreciated if you give this video a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Thank you very much for watching. Until next time, I will see you later.